Good morning, Mr. Nunberg. My name is Carter Bell.
Hi, my name is Olivia Acosta. Welcome back to Oak Meadow, where awesome leadership begins. First, we want to thank you for representing us here in San Antonio. You stand for greatness. We don't have time to mention everything that makes San Antonio wonderful and fantastic, so we will just share one word, the people. We love San Antonio. People don't give up on people. Everyone cares. We love the Alamo and the parks. However, we could use more parks. And there are activities for all ages. We also don't have time to mention everything that makes Oak Meadow shine, so we will share one word, the people. We show great leadership here. We have the freedom to lead. We volunteer. Carter and I are SOC buddies. SOC stands for Service Off Campus, which allows us to connect and communicate with younger students. All of us help people to do good things, just like you. We are a lighthouse school, which means we work very hard to learn and lead. And most important, Oak Meadow teaches all of us how to be successful in life. We stand for greatness, learners and leaders, Mr. Ron Ehrenberg.
Good morning, Mavericks.
Good morning.
Good morning, all. Thank you for having me back in your school. It's a real honor for me. I don't live too far away, so I get to see some of you driving to school sometimes. My name is Ron Ehrenberg, and I'm your city councilman. How many of you know what a city councilman is? Yeah? Charlie, I bet you know. What is it, a city councilman?
A city councilman is somebody who people complain to. He goes to court, and they make some complaints happen.
Not bad. So I get to hear complaints. Rocco. Work in a group and make decisions to make the city better? Yes, ma'am.
City councilman is someone who works in the city hall and they kind of make the decisions in the city laws.
Very good. And I saw one more hand in the back. No? Well, you all are right. I'm one of 10 city councilmen. We all divide the city into 10 equal areas. And then we also have one mayor who oversees the entire city. My name is Ron Ehrenberg, and I've got District 8, which is the northwest area of San Antonio, and I've been in office now since 2013. I was elected twice, once in 2013, and now again just last May. And how many of you know who our mayor is? Yeah? Anybody volunteer? That's right. Well, very good. Well, you all know who a city councilman is, what he does, or what a mayor does. But I want to kind of dive into that a little bit and talk a little bit about what we do and how we get there. So everyone knows what when your elections are, and everyone's excited about voting?
Yes.
Are you excited about voting? Raise your hand if you're excited about voting. Oh, come on. How many of you are excited about one day voting? Okay, how many of you can vote? Keep your hand raised if you can vote. Only the teachers in the back. That's right. Well, I want to do a little experiment. How many of you think it's important to vote? Yeah, I want to see all those hands raised again. And the things that I do at City Hall, when I hear complaints or when I try to fix sidewalks or streets, or we make sure that there's police on the street to help keep us safe, those are all the decisions that a city councilman has to make. And we deal with the budget, so making sure that we have money to pay for all of the services that we provide. But I want to do a little experiment. Today, I talked to your teachers, and they have given me the authority that I get to decide how we're going to have lunch and when we're going to have lunch. And so what I decided to do is that we're going to do a little democratic experiment, and it's going to be based on San Antonio. So let me see, let me count off a few people. I think there's 75 students here. Right around, okay. Carter. Rose. Maybe. Magic? Let's see. That's three, right? Is that four?
That's three.
Johnny, Isabella, and Lauren. Okay. I want all the people I call to sit right over there. Right in the back row there. Perfect. Quiet. Okay. Now, raise your hand if you have an idea of what you want to have for lunch. Anthony, what would you like for lunch?
Sandwich.
Okay. Antonio, what would you like for lunch?
Nachos.
Okay. Brittany. Papa John's. I like that idea.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, well, you know what? Y'all put your hands down. When would you like to have lunch? Right now?
Yeah.
Call it a day and go lunch. Okay. You know what I've just decided? You guys don't matter. All I care about is what these folks think right now. You don't have to worry about whatever anybody else wants. You just tell me what you want to do, and that's what we're going to do. So who guys say that? These are your student leaders right now. It doesn't matter. I'm appointing them. So Carter, what would you like that one? Subway? Papa John's? Baked potato cheese? Macaroni cheese? I bet you should pick one of these because whoever wins out of the two of you.
She's my imposter.
Oh.
Wherever the most expensive place in the U.S.
Okay. So you have all these choices. Just need one more vote. No. Only these people matter. How many of y'all think that we should eat at the most expensive place in the USA? Sounds like a good idea. How many of you like the idea that I'm only asking those folks?
No.
No? Why not? Isn't that fair? Alright. Well, let me tell you something. That happens every single day in our city. That happens every single day in our city. I'll explain to you why. Okay, you guys can go back to your seats now.
Yes, please.
That was and for you folks in the lighthouse, you have a really great metaphor for your mission statement where you're trying to get the kindergartners through the sea of kindergarten and onto the shores of fifth grade. That's a metaphor. What I was trying to do right there is a metaphor for how our city runs. And the reason is, you all raise your hands that you are excited about voting, but you all put your hands down because you picked vote. Well, let me tell you, how many of you know how old you have to be to vote? I heard it. Okay, good. Everybody knows. You have to register to vote. And city of San Antonio has almost 1.5 million people in the city of San Antonio. Roughly about a little bit more than half of those folks are old enough, and they've turned in a card that says, I want to vote. Roughly about half, so maybe about 750,000. Don't fact check me because I know I'm wrong on that number. About 750,000 people are voting. Any idea? How many of those 750,000 people who are eligible to vote, who can vote, who have turned in their card and are old enough to vote, how many of those people actually turn out, give me a percent, and actually vote?
25%.
25%? Are you pessimistic?
15.
Pessimistic? 15. All right. Okay. Yeah. thinks Ben's right?
Yes.
No? Who has a better idea? Luke.
75.
That would be, you mean 25% of people can vote, but they chose not to be part of the lunchtime conversation? They just don't do that? Madison.
Madison.
25. That's even worse than he said.
Charlie.
50. Okay. Well, who said 10%?
Ben.
You're right.
What?
Isn't that shocking? Of all the 18-year-olds and older and people that your parents' age and your teachers and so forth, of all the people who can vote and be part of that conversation and make the decision about where we're going to have lunch or where, what time we're going to have lunch or how much money we should spend on your streets and sidewalks or how many fire trucks we need on the road, of all the people who participate in that discussion, only 1 out of 10 do it. How does that make you feel? Okay. Now, how many of you are now even more excited when you turn 18 to turn in your voter registration card and vote? Okay. Now, here's what I want to explain to you. You don't have to be 18 to make a difference in your community. We've been doing this Kids Town Hall all year. We go around the schools. We try to do at least one every 3 months. And we come to our schools. I've been out at Oak Meadow twice, and we get to listen to what your concerns are. Because there are so many people in our community who don't get a chance to vote because they're too young, or they haven't quite registered, or they just moved here and haven't been living here long enough to be able to vote. We need to make sure that we're listening to them. And you all have great ideas, and I want to give you an example of something that just happened that will hopefully excite you to be part of this process. Last year, I went to a middle school called Hector B. Garcia. I don't know if anyone has heard of that. I think they're the Garcia Gladiators. They're out on Pile Seal Parkway. And those students, much like you all, have to walk to school on a sidewalk. But their subdivisions were built in a place where it didn't have any rules whether or not they had to put in sidewalks. So they had to walk right next to the street where cars are going about 45 miles an hour. Very dangerous, right? We didn't know. This is a big place. A city in San Antonio has almost 500 square miles and we have 10 people to kind of watch things and look at how they are. So the students, when I went to the Kids Town Hall, they had two presentations. And they came up and they said, "Mr. Nuremberg, we have a problem with our sidewalks, and we need your help." And it was so impressive to me. They thought that if they talked to their city councilman, even though they couldn't vote, that we could somehow get a sidewalk built to get it be more safer to get to school. Well, just last week, me and my buddy Ray, who works in our office, we got to go walk with them for the first time on their new sidewalk. And that's because we just Kids Town Hall. Kids Town Hall, just like this, they said that this is something wrong with our community and we need it fixed. And being part of a town hall like this is the best way. Beyond voting is one of the best ways that you can be involved in your community. So I want to challenge you that when you go home tonight, not only do you tell your parents that you learned that even before you vote, I know for some of you it's maybe 7-8 years away, even before you vote, you can make a difference in your community. And so that's what today's all about. I want to take questions from you. I want to learn about what's important, what's on your mind, what's going on that we can help improve, maybe some things that are going well in your neighborhoods. But we want to learn what's going on so we can help you improve it. And you have a voice in your community. And so I want you to use it. I want you to be excited about using it. I want to show you that local government, the people on the city council, and the folks that are fixing the streets, and the folks that are patrolling your neighborhoods really want to help you live in a great San Antonio. So how many of you are still excited about living in San Antonio? All right, good. How many of you now think that if you're not quite excited one day, you can make a change and make a difference with that? No, come on, come on. I'm sorry, maybe I wasn't clear. How many of you want to make a difference in your community to make it better? All right, so you guys ready to do that today?
Yes.
All right, so let's go. I see that some of you have some presentations or some signs made. I was going to go right into question and answer, but if you have some direction for me and who wants to present, we can do that too. You want to start? No, you don't want to start? That's a very important initiative. Back in 2005, when a former mayor, Mayor Hartberger, came in office, San Antonio, hopefully nobody's squeezing here, I'll just be factual. But San Antonio was unfortunately having to euthanize about 30,000, I believe it's about 30,000 dogs every year, because there were so many strays on the street that had to be picked up and there weren't any adoptions and some of them were dangerous animals. When Mayor Hartberger came into office, it was the worst of the worst. And from then on, we decided that we wanted to make sure that San Antonio becomes a place that's humane for its animals. And so far, we've been working on what's called a no-kill strategy, meaning that we want to try to get San Antonio to become a place where the strays that are brought in are released live to families that want to adopt them. So far, we're up to almost 90%. So we've done a great, great job. Just 2 years ago, we built a new shelter, so we took some of that tax money, that's your money, and we built some new shelters so we can have more space to keep the animals, but we still need to do better. And one of the things that we need to do better on is educate, teach each other about what responsible pet ownership is. Making sure that, you know, when you see your friends really want to have a dog, that if they're going to go and buy that animal, that they're committed to taking care of it. They don't let it loose and, you know, reproduce with animals that become stray. So it's a great point. Thank you very much, Isa, for bringing it to our attention. So I know Carter. He's my neighbor. In fact, his sister is sometimes a babysitter for my family. So.
Our problem is, we have our thing is called Solar Solution. The problem is people don't realize that we are going to run out of fossil fuels. The more we use, the more the environment suffers. The pollution for the end of us. Another problem is that electric things cost more than what most people have. Our solution would be solar power, because we'd use less fossil fuels and we could raise fundraisers for the poor so they could afford solar power ones. Once we convert this to solar power, other states will get jealous and they will convert so that we could we can keep the environment friendly country. Solar power doesn't work at night, so we could use electric.
Basically,
solar powers on our solar panels on our house. To charge it, we can just plug whatever we need into the wall.
Battery.
Yeah. And we got a couple pictures. I know what the greenhouse solar with the solar panel roof. And this is the door solar power that all the trees are getting into permission about that solar. And there's a solar powered car and this one is after solar power. The trees are getting it when there's the sun.
Good job, guys. Can I take these, or are you guys going to take them back to class?
You can have them.
I would like to take these in the office. So, great point. I heard a couple things in there. One of them was solar power and energy production, which we need a lot of energy to power our city. The factories or the homes and the businesses. But I also heard air pollution. And that's one thing that we're working very hard on. In fact, at noon today, I'm going to give a talk to a lot of the county judges and the elected officials in the Bexar County area talking about what we can do together to help improve air quality. And that's precisely for the reason, because we know that bad air quality has a cost to not only our environment, like the trees that you were drawing, but also our health. We have a lot of cases of asthma and different lung issues when there's poor air quality. And we know today our air quality is suffering so much that the federal government is going to call us a city that has bad air. And it's not just name calling, it comes with a lot of federal rules. Yes, sir?
How does pollution mutate your cells?
Well, that's a great question. I don't know the answer to it, but it does. And there have been studies to show that young children that live in areas with the worst air quality, not like San Antonio, which has relatively good air compared to other cities, there have been studies to show that some children are born with lung defects because of the air. So real quick on the solar part of it, you will be happy to know that we've been working with CPS Energy, which I think for most of you would supply your energy, and we're going to be rolling out a solar power program that makes it cheaper and faster for people in their homes to put solar panels on the roof. So when you get home tonight, and if you're really excited about solar, make sure you tell your parents to watch out for the new program coming from CPS, because you'll be able to put some solar power on your roof and contribute to improving our air quality and getting us less dependent on those fossil fuels you're talking about. Michael. So that is a challenge. So Michael was asking, is it too expensive for solar power? And a lot of people have been concerned about this. It has been very expensive to do solar power, and that's one of the reasons why we aren't currently doing it right now as much as we could. But the new program that I was talking about is going to make it easier for people to put it on their solar power, because CPS, the energy company, will pay for the units, pay for the equipment, and then we get a return back from their community solar power program.
Will it take a while to
install it?
Yes.
It'll probably take a few months, so you have to put your name down and get in line. Let me take one more question, and then we'll get to the next presentation. I thought I saw a hand in the back. Do you have a question? Johnny has a question.
It's not really a question, but I know that we have an RV and we used to have a generator and we put solar panels on the top of it. I mean, my dad just went out and bought some solar panels and installed them in like an afternoon on the top of our RV, and it's like more fun, like to check them and like see how the energy is going.
You don't have to stop the gas as much. And you brought up a good point about what happens at night. Well, the technology for the batteries is getting much better too, so we can get all the sun we can in the daytime hours, and then we can store them in batteries and put that power to use even when it's not light outside. So, all right, Tommy, you're up.
Oh.
problem is that people are cutting down too many trees. The solution is we can plant trees in community areas all around the world. We do need to cut down trees, but just when you cut down one, plant two.
So, and then Jamie has an example about where she lives. So,
A storage unit has torn down Castle Hills Forest and is threatening it to become just Castle Hills because it's really.
So, we drew pictures on our poster that show before. This is a lot of pollution and just a bunch of business industries, and you don't see any trees anywhere. But then the after shows, it's kind of like a little park area, and there are lots of green trees growing, and it's just where kids can play around, and like everyone can have fun. So, me and my friend, we kind of made this little saying, and it goes like this. Would you rather live in plain black and gray or beautiful colors? Which one, the beautiful trees or the black industry buildings? And then how this affects us is,
well, these trees make the air we breathe, so if there weren't any, we wouldn't really be alive.
Trees make good homes for animals, so do you want them living in a tree where they can't bother you or in your chimney?
And we're losing the nature feel, like all these industries are just cutting down forests and there's no just trees around anymore, really.
So would you rather sit in an industry doing a bunch of paperwork every day or go outside to a park filled with lots of trees and get to play with your children and your friends and family?
Oh,
save the trees. How many of you agree with that? All right, good. And I love the fact that I know the storage unit. This is in our district, and we saw it go up, and we were also very disappointed to see how many trees were
and
cut down.
Also, if you look at Casa Group, they're building in the middle.
Yeah.
They chopped down the whole.
Yes. So, and I like this. We don't want to turn Castle Hills Forest into Castle Hills. That's very good. Well, let me talk to you a little bit about trees. Trees are extremely important. You're absolutely right. They're beautiful. They give us good quality of life. As you said, they clean the air. That thing about air pollution we talked about, trees help with that. Trees are also on people's property, and this is where it gets difficult. I believe, as you do, that we need to save and plant as many trees as we possibly can. And where I need your help is to make sure that you tell your parents just how much they're important to you.
Boggins' class, and the problem that we're going to be presenting to you is that San Antonio is, like, really low on our parks and trees. So, in this picture, you see a really dull, boring city without any trees or parks. This girl coughing, she represents that the air isn't clean because we don't have any trees to keep it clean, and everyone is, like, mad, and it's really dull. And then there's a ditch at the bottom, and that's a really dry ditch, so that shows that we're not getting enough water, and the concrete buildings that we have, they're just letting all the water sit on top of them and not going through the ground into the aquifer. So this is our solution picture. So, well, this is a fun, happy place. And it has many trees and parks, and everyone is having a great time. As you can see, everyone's just smiling and having a great time and playing. They have clean air and plenty of water. So, from these two pictures, here are some benefits. So, the first benefit is we get cleaner air, children can play, adults can exercise, we have a prettier city and more wildlife and water. So now, Maisie will read the disadvantages.
Thanks, Addison. So we couldn't really think of that many disadvantages, but one major one that we had was we might need to rezone for parks because, like, we had places zoned for buildings and industries to go, but, like, those would be really nice places for parks. So you would need to rezone, and we would have some less businesses, which means our city wouldn't be able to grow as fast.
All right. How many of y'all agree with that? Very good job. And so I'm curious, Maisie and Addison, where you all got your urban affairs degrees. That's quite advanced, even down to the disadvantages. One of the challenges that we have with creating more park space, it says here, might need to rezone, is that there are, we talked about private property rights here a minute ago. There are certain rules in place that say that property owners can put one thing or another on a particular piece of property. Some of them are zoned to parks, some of them are not. So when we look for park space, we have to acquire, buy the property, and then we have to rezone it. So how many of you have been to Hardberger Park? Yeah? And put your hand down if you don't like Hardberger Park. Everybody's hand still raised. You do like Hardberger Park. You're right. There's two on either side of Wurzbach. Okay, you put your hands down. So this is a great example of what we can do together using our money to make sure that we have more park space. That was a little piece of property that was supposed to become a giant retail development. And I mentioned former Mayor Hardberger got wind of that and said, you know what, that's one of the most pristine places in our entire city. It's 300 plus acres, and it would make a beautiful park, and we don't have a park on the side of town. So he worked very hard against a lot of odds to acquire that property. We bad cake? Oh, good cake and bad cake. Yeah, I like good cake.
Thank you.
sign, stop speeding. Our problems are too many people are speeding, and that's a problem to our community because that will make things dangerous for people to get hit by cars. Then people are perishing from that. Because people get hit by cars when people are speeding, because when they go on the street and when they're speeding, it takes a while for them to slow down.
Our solutions are more speed bumps that make people go slower on the cars. And also, the sky's the police officers, so they'll just speed right past the police officers and they can easily catch the people who are speeding. And then more radar speed systems. It's, you know those things that are like,
say that one again. I don't think people heard you.
Don't crack the speed limit, or the speed limit won't be the only thing cracking.
Very good.
Okay, and we have a song to sing about speeding, and we are the anti-speeders. Okay. Speeding, speeding, it's really, really terrible. Speeding, speeding, it's against the law too. Speeding, speeding, it gets your license taken away. Speeding, you'll get your driving restricted. Speeding, you'll get your license taken away. Speeding, it'll cost you money too, and maybe prison too. Don't speed, everybody! Stop speeding!
Good job, Charlie. Way to go. All right. Wow. So I would guarantee that if you guys perform that song, on the corner where we're having the most problems with the speeding and the running of the stop signs, people would stop. Because that was very well done. Thank you guys for that. And actually, I'm really glad to have Ray Garza here, who is my district director. He works with this issue almost every single day. But one of our biggest challenges
7 miles away from the school. Like, not like two, like a mile at least away. And why he said this is because of the fumes from the gas. They can get in the school sometimes. And like if somebody actually rams into a gas station, then the gas starts flooding everywhere. Then you can probably smell it at the school. And by Jackson Middle School, there's a gas station that sells like a lot of like alcohol and stuff. And we don't want like kids that are not very smart coming running and stealing some alcohol because it's middle school. And yeah.
Good job. Well done. Very good. I think it's Carter's show now, so.
Thank you for coming, and thank you for asking us about to think about our concerns in our city and how we would like to see them changed. This is Habit 8. Use your voice and inspire others to use theirs. This is what you have done by inviting us to be a part of the Town Hall Challenge. We hope you have enjoyed this unique and ubiquitous school. Unique meaning special because it allows the student to become a better person. And ubiquitous meaning we are learners and leaders everywhere all the time, even when no one is looking.
Well, I guess I'll wrap up by saying thank you very much for sharing your thoughts and your concerns with me. It is inspiring for me to know that you all care so much because, again, you can't even vote, but you have that much care and concern for your community. So we're going to act and make sure that these suggestions that you have made